kind of what they call ballads, and I thought that would fit in pretty good with it. Ask him, ready? Okay. It's all the same, holding a name that changed every day. It seems we're wasted away. Another place where the faces are so cold. I travel all night just to get back home. I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. I'm wanted, dead or alive. Wanted. I consider myself an entertainer. One of my characters is Michael Jackson. You know, I never stop creating, I never stop getting ready. You know, you have to be, when you're an entertainer and a performer, you really have to be ready at all times. I actually practice 20 hours a week or more, depending on the time I have. And once you hit the stage, all that energy just explodes. I like to listen to mainly 80s retro at times, songs that have a catchy hook or a riff in it. When you're doing the art, which I call it art of karaoke, there's usually like a TV monitor that's right in front of you for words. What sets me apart is I won't actually do a karaoke song unless I know it in my head. I try to or like to perform it as if I'm an actual concert as a star, because that was my all-time dream, was to be a star. And like me, I've taken it and I've tried to give it a life. You know, it's something that beyond what people usually see every day. You don't want to just take things as far as you can take them. You want to try to take things beyond, you know, imaginability and take things to an upper level plateau of greatness. Get a reaction throughout the song itself, from the moment I start to the moment I end. It usually ends up being a standing ovation almost 90 to 95% of the time. People are always on their feet. You know, they're screaming, they're yelling. You know, they're either yelling Michael, Michael, or John G, John G. That's what I actually look for, being an artist myself. I'll actually do karaoke until my vocal can't go no further, until my body just gives out on its energy, but I will continue to pursue the dream I've been after for years.